26 minutes of terror. A Pasco County mother holds an intruder at gunpoint while she waits and waits for deputies. Our Raid on Your Side investigation broke the story yesterday. Tonight, we are uncovering new details. Here's the background. Pasco County deputies did not respond to the first 911 call about a suspicious person for 26 minutes. Neighbors think that's just too long. But now we've learned the delay is not the only disturbing part of this call. Now we have the dramatic body camera video, and it makes clear deputies believe this intruder was mentally ill.
And at the time, deputies struggled to determine whether he could be charged with a crime. And as 8 on Your Side investigative reporter Masa Saidi found out, this happens more than you might think.
Keith Stacey, just in Pasco County alone so far this year, deputies have taken someone to a mental health facility more than 1,500 times.
Multiple units racing. While four kids sleep, a mother is holding an alleged intruder at gunpoint. The intruder tells a disturbing story.
My grandmother and grandfather, I'm pretty sure they just got raped and murdered.
A sergeant first on scene.
I got my wallet, all my money, my social security card.
Who did?
Whoever the just ran, okay. ran up in my grandmother's house.
Do me a favor and relax, okay?
Devin Cook, suspected of breaking into a neighbor's garage, appears to be in crisis.
He is schizophrenic.
Deputy stopped by his mother's house after Devin claims people are dead.
He said he had tinfoil on his head.
Did he make any odd statements?
Everything he says is odd because he's off of his meds. Gotcha.
Meantime, the sergeant finds the mom who held her young man at gunpoint.
I have four babies in there, 7 down to 5 months.
Loren Richards just experienced 26 minutes of terror. Half the time, she says, she was holding Cook at gunpoint after he broke into her garage.
We were actually looking for him anyways.
For some
other things, not because of stuff like this, but for some mental health issues.
Before all this, Cook had been ordered to have a mental health evaluation. The question then turns to whether he can be charged with a crime.
So quite frankly, the fact that he is dealing with a mental health issue and that we're going to take him for an evaluation for that based on a court order, I don't think that we could reasonably justify charging him with that crime as well.
Another deputy explaining further.
His intent's not there, you know.
Okay.
Feeling frustrated with the police investigation, neighbors contacted 8 on Your Side.
I was surprised they didn't take any of our statements.
After we started asking questions, neighbors say deputies went back, took statements and pictures. Tonight, this Pasco report shows Cook will now face a felony charge.
How often does mental health intersect with the criminal justice system?
All the time. It's a big problem.
Attorney Stephen Capriotti prosecuted crimes in Hillsborough County for more than 5 years. At least half his cases touched by this epidemic.
Is there a time where, because of your mental instability, you don't have the intent to commit that crime?
That you get into a very legally technical question. And yes, there are times where you can't form the intent.
But even prosecutors do not make the final call there.
It's not up to the public defender's office or the defense counsel to determine.
Or police.
It's up to the judge.
As this incident with Cook shows, it can be a tough call for law enforcement. They're often the first responders to a psychiatric emergency, even if it does not involve a crime. Local agencies don't keep stats related to crime and mental illness, but we know deputies are often transporting individuals to medical health facilities. So far this year, it happened more than 1,200 times in Polk, 1,300 in Pinellas, and 1,500 in Pasco. Capriotti says you must treat the mental health condition and then let the court system take over. The only problem is
the court system doesn't have the available resources and the mental health facilities don't have the available resources. There needs to be more resources.
So why doesn't Florida have the resources necessary to treat all of the mentally ill people, whether or not they have committed a crime? Tomorrow, we're going to take you inside our overwhelmed system, and you're going to hear from the people who try to help these patients each and every single day.
Okay, so as we just heard, the judge is the one who makes the ultimate determination when it comes to intent. In this situation, how scary to have somebody mentally unstable and guns involved.
Yeah, it could have ended really differently, as you were saying, as we watched that package. Capriotti says there's always a competency hearing, and the judge is the one to make that decision about mental health, and that's based on what the mental health experts say. So that's not a decision for prosecutors. It's not for police. It is up to a judge in consultation with what the mental health experts say. So very complicated.
All right. Thank you, Masa. And if you have a problem you want Masa to investigate, you can give her a call. There's the 8 on Your Side helpline number, 1-800-338-0808.